Yes, students. Now we are going to discuss about the dura mater. First, what is meant by dura mater? Dura mater, it is the outermost covering of the brain, or it's a layer of the meninges. Our brain, it is covered with the three coverings. What are the outermost dura mater? Deep to the dura mater, arachnoid mater, then pia mater. Okay. See this model. This is the model of the cerebrum. Okay. So immediately outside the cerebrum, there we can see one layer. That one is a pia mater. Outer to the pia mater, next layer, arachnoid mater. Outer to the arachnoid mater, the third layer, that is what the dura mater. So dura mater, arachnoid mater, and pia mater. Those are the three layers of the meninges. Those three layers together known as the meninges. Okay. So we are going to discuss the details of this dura mater. Dura mater, it is the outermost and the thickest membrane is covering of the brain. It is having two layers. This dura mater is having two layers, outer endosteal layer and inner meningeal layer. See how. Now this is a, imagine this is a cerebrum and this paper piece has the dura mater. See, imagine this is a dura mater covering the cerebrum. Now this dura mater, it is having two layers. It looks like a single layer, but it is having two layers. What are they? Say this outer layer. See, this layer, it is related to the bones, or it is closely related to the bones. It is known as what? Endosteal layer. Osteum means bone. Okay, so endosteal layer. The next layer, this layer, it is related to the brain. Okay, that one is a meningeal layer. So dura mater, it is having. So imagine this is my dura mater. Okay, so dura mater, it is having this outer layer, endosteal layer, and this inner layer, meningeal layer. In some areas, this inner meningeal layer shows some foldings like this. I told you, this one is a endosteal layer, this one is a meningeal layer. Okay, so this inner meningeal layer shows some foldings like this. Now here you can see the folding of the meningeal layer. Okay, this folding, this type of foldings are known as dural fold. Okay, such a major four foldings are there. We are going to see the details of those four foldings. What are they? What are the sinuses related to that? Yes, then comes the question, what is meant by sinus? Okay, so here dural venous sinus. See, inside this folding, there we can see some spaces. This type of spaces are known as dural venous sinuses. Dural venous sinuses. Venous, why it is known as venous sinus? Venous blood accumulate there, or it act as a vein. So venous sinus, where it is seen in that space. Sinus means of space. So dural, it is seen inside the dura mater, so dural. And venous blood accumulate there, so venous. And it's a space, so dural venous sinus. So this inside the meningeal layer, some spaces are seen known as dural venous sinuses. So we have to discuss the details of those foldings. So first point, it is clear it is having outer endosteal layer and inner meningeal layer. Then I told you meningeal layer shows some foldings. What are the foldings? Fold cerebrae, endurium cerebellae, fold cerebellae, and diaphragm muscle. Here we have to discuss the details of these two points, fold cerebrae and endurium cerebellae. First we have to go through the fold cerebrae. What is meant by fold cerebrae? Fold cerebrae is a sickle shaped fold seen between two cerebral hemispheres. See, almost like this. See, it's a sickle shaped fold. See, like this, with the two ends, one anterior end which is pointed and a posterior end which is broad, and two borders. See, one lower border, one upper border, then two surfaces, one outer surface and one right surface and one left surface. So these are the details of this fold cerebrae. It's having two ends, anterior end which is pointed, posterior end which is broad, then two borders, superior border which is convex and inferior border which is concave. See, this is the concave border and this one is a convex border. Then two surfaces, right surface and left surface. So this sickle shaped fold, it is known as false cerebrae. Where it is seen? It is seen between these two cerebral hemispheres. Same, these are the two cerebral hemispheres which is connected by the corpus callosum and is separated by a fissure. So here we can see a gap between these two cerebral hemispheres. This gap, it is known as longitudinal fissure. See here inside the longitudinal fissure, this whole cerebra is seen inside the longitudinal fissure like this. See this arrangement. Okay, so these are the some of the details of this fold cerebrae. I will see the details. So it is having, I told you, it is having two ends, anterior end, which is narrow, and connected to the crista galli. Next point, connected to the crista galli. What is that crista galli? See here, this is the cranial cavity. Okay, this cranial cavity is divided into anterior cranial cavity, middle cranial cavity, and posterior cranial cavity. This anterior cranial cavity, here in the middle part, we are having a small projection. This projection, this is what the crista galli. So anterior end is connected to this, or here comes the anterior end, and the anterior end is connected to this crista galli. Posterior end, which comes here, and it is connected to tendorium cerebellae. Superior surface of the tendorium cerebellae, I will show you later. Okay, so anterior end, it is narrow and connected to the crista galli. Posterior end, which is broad, and it is attached to the upper end of the tendorium cerebellae, that we will discuss it later. Now, two margins or two borders. See, upper margin, which is convex, and attached to the lips of the sagittal sulcus. What is meant by that? See, this is what the sagittal sulcus. See, this one is the sagittal sulcus. Where it is seen? It is seen inside the or inner surface of the vault. Vault means what? This is skull cap. Okay, this area of the skull, this convex part of the skull, it is known as what, the skull cap or the vortex. It's interior. When we check the interior, so imagine this is what the interior of the vault. Inside or inner surface of the vault is having a groove. Okay, here we can see that image. This is the inner surface of the vault. So here, inner surface of the vault is having a groove. This groove, which is known as the sagittal sulcus. The sagittal sulcus is having two margins. See, this ridge. This is one side margin, and this ridge, opposite side margin. These margins of this sulcus, it is known as what? Lips. Okay. Now that point is clear. It is connected to the lips of the sagittal sulcus, means these two ridges. It is attached to this. Those two ridges. So upper margin, which is convex and attached to the lips of the sagittal sulcus. Lower margin, which is concave and free. Then two surfaces, right and left surface. So details are clear. Anterior end, posterior end. Then upper margin, lower margin, right and left surface. Then it is having some sinuses. I told you what is meant by sinus. Sinus means those are the spaces where the venous blood accumulates. That's why venous sinus. The full name is dural venous sinus. Okay. The venous sinus seen inside the dura mater. So dural venous sinus. What are the dural venous sinuses seen in relation with this false cerebrae? See, along the superior border, it is having superior sagittal sinus. And along the inferior border, it is having inferior sagittal sinus. Then along the posterior end, it is having straight sinus. See, this is a false cerebrae. Anterior end, posterior end. See, along the upper border. See this one. This is the this space. That is the superior sagittal sinus along the lower border. This space. Okay, that one is inferior sagittal sinus along the posterior end. This is a straight sinus. Now the details of the false cerebrae is clear.